around 8 to 12 feet in length, and they weigh up to 500 pounds. Close to the shoreline, we spot these dolphins. They are so small that they just stay near shore. They can safely get into just 2 to 3 feet of water. Sometimes they're really close to the beach.
surprised me.
If you guys are interested in knowing the depth of water that you're in throughout your trip, you go inside the cabin, you're going to see a big TV monitor set up in there. And that is hooked up to our pilot house, so you guys can see real-time exactly what happens to the scene as well. On the right-hand side, it will show you the depth of water below the boat.
Alicia! Nana!
So right now, it's reading about 17 feet. You guys have been looking at those right over there, right side. Oh, you've been examining those dorsal fins of these dolphins. You might also just kind of have very luxury looking stuff hanging out those dorsal fins. A lot of people will ask us if those are tags. And no, they are not tags, and we don't even need to tag the dolphins to know where else they travel, because we can utilize that photo identification. They're coming right over to the bow. Utilize that photo identification instead, which is very non-intrusive. That black string looking stuff is actually a type of soft barnacle. It hitches a ride on the dolphins, feeding all the dolphins are swimming along. It's very natural that they have them. Still over here off our right side. Okay, near the mouth of Chesapeake Bay, and utilize that part like a nursery. So that's what we like to go to have their babies, which means we get the chance to see lots of little adorable baby dolphins here right along our coast. Coming really close to our right side, checking you guys out. Wave back to them. People ask us if we see sharks out here. Well, of course we can't. It's an ocean. We don't tend to get a lot of really large shark species here along our coastline, but anything's possible. But for these dolphins, they don't really have much for natural predators. Unfortunately, the biggest threat to these dolphins are us humans. Things such as trash and pollution in the water, even overfishing, can be detrimental to these dolphins. I do want to make sure you guys get all your trash to our trash can while we're out here today. Anything that you can do on a daily basis, such as reducing your plastic use, even shopping locally, the less shipments from overseas we get, the better for our ocean animals. And little things like not releasing balloons into the air. Virginia just recently passed a ban on balloon releases, which is awesome news for our local wildlife. A lot of ocean animals, including sea turtles, can mistake those balloons in the water for fish or for food and actually ingest them. You'll notice a lot of the products that we have on board we get from here locally in Virginia Beach or even in the state of Virginia. And a lot of them are also biodegradable. So even those cups that you guys use that look like they're made out of plastic, they're actually made out of plants.
Really close to the left side.
One of the best parts about coming out here and seeing these dolphins in their natural habitat is that every single one of our trips is completely different. You never know what we're going to get out here. There's different dolphins, different behaviors all the time. If you guys have looked at one off the trip there, it's going to be very close to those today. I'm going to go to the side here. Really close to our right side. Just can't get enough of the ocean wildlife we have out here. If you want to spend the entire day out to sea with us, just check out our pelagic wildlife exploration trips. They are 13-hour trips. They head about 70 miles offshore. You see all sorts of different kind of wildlife out there. Every trip is a little bit different. We have pirate whales, rhythm dolphins, common dolphins, spotted dolphins, fin whales, cat whales,
his teeth.